Greetings from the Remnant Bible School Church. It's time for Nuggets. Amen. We're going to read from Psalms 43. Be thou my judge, O God, and plead my cause against an ungodly nation, and deliver me from the deceitful and unjust man. For thou art the God of my strength. Why hast thou cast me off? Why go I mourning under oppression of the enemy? Oh, send out thy light and thy truth. Let them lead me. Let them bring me unto thy holy mountain and to thy dwelling places. Then will I go unto thine altar of God and unto God my exceeding joy. And praise thee upon the harp I will, O my God, my God. Why art thou cast me down, O my soul? And why mournest thou within me? Hope thou in God, for I shall yet praise him, the salvation of my countenance and my God. We bless the Lord. For I trust not in my bow, neither can my sword save me. But thou hast saved us from our adversaries and hast put them to shame that hate us. In God have we glorified all the day, and we will give thanks unto thy name forever, Salakia. Amen. Shalom, everybody. We're going right into the scriptures. Amen. 1 Samuel 9 and 19. When Samuel answered Saul, he said, I am the seer, and you will eat with me today. You will eat with me tomorrow. But before I leave, I'm going to tell you everything that's in your heart. Amen. That's a nice little nugget there. Back in the old days, they used to read the case before they left. They would never just come to your house and not leave a word with you. Amen. 1 Samuel 25 verse 34, you know, back in those days, there wasn't much talk about the baptism of the Holy Ghost as such, and they had to depend on God to hold them back when they really wanted to hurt people that maybe they shouldn't have hurt. Amen. Well, I can't really cite it. Yes, I can. 1 Samuel 25 and 34 says, hold me back, Lord, as the Lord liveth, which have kept me back from hurting thee. Amen. So sometimes when we walk away, it's not because we're scared and coward. It's because we don't want to bring any hurt to anyone. 1 Samuel 26 and 9, David said to Abijah, destroy him not, for who can stretch forth their hand against the anointed and be guiltless? There's nobody and nothing that can stretch forth a hand to anybody with any kind of anointing and be guiltless. You can say whatever you like. Do whatever you like, but you're not guiltless. Not with God. In the same 1 Samuel, the man asked the question, should I leave out the wine which cheers both God and man? Amen. They got so many hiccups about wine. I don't understand what's really going on with that part. But let's see another nugget taken from Judges 9, verse 13 to 15. Something like the Lord of the Rings. You know, they may be reading the Bible and taking the ideas, because here we got talking trees and listening trees and trees that answer back. The trees listened, the trees answered, and they spoke back. Bless the Lord. I didn't write it. It's in the Bible. Amen. Judges 9, verse 13 to 15. Bless the Lord. And we are likened unto trees as well. So don't certain question you might want to bring saying, oh, you know, actually we're the trees. I already know that. I'm only going by this verse. Amen. Amen. There was a sign sent to Gilead though. From Judges 6 and 40, the sign of Gilead, it talks about it. It's a big sermon. Amen. Part was dry, part was wet. Amen. But after the sign of Gilead, they said it's a wicked and a perverse nation that seeks after a sign. So no, there are already signs in place. Amen. There's enough signs, really. There are enough signs to let you know something's wrong and something's up. Amen. Judges 6 and 34, the Spirit came upon Gideon and he blew the trumpet. Amen. Now, the Bible said that in Judges 6 and 34 that the Spirit came upon Gideon. Amen. So the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, has been used to landing on people and anointing them and blessing them to do certain things. Now, what did he bless Gideon to do? To blow the trumpet. So he blew that trumpet in the spirit. God is a spirit, ladies and gentlemen, and they that worship him must worship him in what? Spirit and in truth. Bless the Lord. In Judges 4, amen, look like 48, amen, it said Barak needed a woman to lead the way. Barak said to the leader of the Israelites at that time. Amen. Deborah, he said, if you will go with me, then I will go. But if you will not go with me, then I will not go. Why? You know how people feel about women in leadership and women going in front and women in charge. I'm not saying everybody. I'm just saying some people got an issue with it. And especially in those provinces back then. But God chose Deborah as a female leader to lead Israel. I said all of Israel, not just the women, the men as well. And it's written right here in Judges 4 and there. It says that Barak said, amen, not Barack Obama. Don't get me a mix up. Not Barack Obama. It says, Barak said, if you go, I'm coming. But if you're not coming with me, I'm not going anywhere because I know God's with you. Amen. The Bible also said that the angel of the Lord spoke to Hagar in Genesis 16. It says that he spoke to Hagar. So Hagar was in communion with the angels, even though she was living in Sarah's house. You know, God is not a respecter of persons. If we humble ourselves and seek his face, he will draw nigh to us. Amen. And some people say, well, you know, Adam ain't even relevant. Adam ain't relevant now. Yes, he is, because they said that Jesus is the second Adam and he sinned not. So yes, first Adam is relevant. He's so relevant, he's got his own city. The city of Adam. Yes, it's found in Joshua chapter 3 and verse 16. Amen. Where it tells us all about the cities of Adam, bless the Lord. Amen. Deuteronomy 7 and 6. For thou art a holy people unto the Lord thy God. And then later on in the New Testament, he said, you are a holy priesthood, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people. You see, because people are going to say that you're peculiar when you start using words like Passover and Rosh Hashanah and fasting and prayer and I believe in God. When you start talking like that, people say you're not normal. Amen. What's not normal, ladies and gentlemen, is for mankind to strive with his maker and to wrestle with the creator of the universe and the heaven and the earth. Also, to ignore totally his Sabbath day of rest, bless the Lord. Deuteronomy 6 and verse 14 says, you shall not go up after other gods of the people. Other gods of the gods of the people. So you got gods that represent the other gods, and the people were following those people who were made gods to worship the other gods. Even those, you shall not tempt the Lord thy God. It's Deuteronomy 6 verse 4, ladies and gentlemen. Numbers 14 and verse 42. It is nugget time. It says, go not up, for the Lord is not among you, that ye be not smitten before your enemies. So that means, make sure when you're going, that God goes with you. Otherwise, the Bible says in Numbers 14 and verse 42, you could get smitten by your enemy. You could lose your court case. You could lose that battle that you got going on. Why? Because it says, go not up, for the Lord is not among you. Make sure that we take the name of God with us. Or go in Jesus' name. Amen. You don't want to go nowhere alone, not in these times. Numbers 14 verse 18. The Lord is long-suffering and of great mercy. He is forgiving of all iniquity and transgressions. And by no means is he clearing the guilty. Now, this is Numbers 14 and 18. You want to know who God is? He does not clear the guilty. Well, you know, Jesus and the blood. Jesus and the blood, he said, forgive us our debts, that we can forgive our debtors. So he still requires us to ask for forgiveness. Don't try the Jesus thing. Exodus chapter 4 and verse 12. Amen. Now therefore go, and I will be with thy mouth, and I will teach thee what to say. So sometimes God's with you, but he ain't with your mouth. Amen. The Bible tells us there in Exodus chapter 4 and verse 12. Now therefore go, and I will be with thy mouth. I'm not only going with you, but I will tell you what to say, because I'm going with your actual mouth. Amen. What a great God we serve. Exodus 3 verse 14. God said unto Moses, I am that I am. Genesis 4 and 6. God said, I will go down with thee into Egypt, and I will also surely bring thee out again. I said Genesis 4, I said verse 6. So when God goes with you into something, the Bible says, I will surely bring thee up again. So he will bring you out of whatever he went in with you to. Whatever you're going in with and you go in with God, he'll bring you right out of it. He's not just going to go in with you and leave you there like some people do. You know, people, they go in with you, but they're not all the way in with you. Amen. I don't know if I've got a witness, but they pretend they're with you, but they're not really with you. They're not with you. They'll tell you all day long that they love you, but they don't love you. They love another. Amen. God is not like that, folks. God said, if I go down with you, be sure that I will bring you out again. Genesis 27 and verse 28. Therefore, the God give thee of the dew of heaven and the fatness of the earth. Amen. Since I've been in America, I've experienced morning dew twice. Bless the Lord. It's not something that you get all the time. It's not something you experience. I know people have lived a whole life and never experienced dew, let alone morning dew. I've experienced it twice in the United States, right here. Genesis 27 verse 28 says, therefore the God give thee of the dew of heaven. So when you meet that, it's God that gives it to you. It's a blessing. Amen. You need to embrace it. Genesis 21 and 17, the angel called to Hagar, which God do they work for? Which God do they work for? Genesis 26 and 24, I am the God of Abraham. See, the angels were communicating with Hagar a long time. So when she went out in the wilderness, she was not alone. The angel came and he met her out there. And he spoke to her and he spoke to her child. We bless the Lord. Genesis 26 and 24 says, I am the God of Abraham. I am that I am. I hope today that you enjoyed your nugget special. Bless the Lord. We haven't done them for a while. Amen. But I hope we've got enough music. Amen. To drop a prayer right now in the name of Jesus. Father, we just thank you at this time for all that you're doing, all that you've already done, and all that you're getting ready to do. We thank you for this ministry and this platform. We thank you for the opportunity to use it and all the others that are using it to fight this warfare. Amen. This spiritual wickedness that's going on in high places. Knowing that we're not wrestling against flesh and blood, Father, we look to you for help and soundness of mind. And again, we thank you for our leaders and those in office, all those in the White House. We pray you will give them wisdom also. Oh God, that we can be led in the right way that we should go. Bless our leaders, oh God. Bless all the leaders beneath our leaders that are leading in other ways. We pray you will touch them. Touch them now, Lord, from the crown of the head to the sole of the feet. And hear us. Hear us when we cry from the Remnant Bible School Church. And we ask you, Lord, to continue to guide and protect us and to continue to provide for us that we can continue to move this way from this platform in Jesus' name. We pray again for all churches, all mosques and all synagogues everywhere and all worshiping centers of the Most High God. Amen. That you will bless your people and keep them safe from all accident, from all hurt, all harm and all danger. In their going out and their coming in from this time forth and now forevermore. In their rising up, down, setting on their right side, their left side, front and behind them. Send your blessing for 1,000 generations to come. Heavenly Father, eternal life is ours if we continue to believe that. But if we believe that we have lost it, we'll lose it. We know that. The devil is a liar and the father of all lies, and we bind him right now in the name of Jesus. We bind his device. We bind all his plans in the name of Jesus, and we stomp them under our feet where there is no power. We're not going to be kept in cages of guilt and shame and suffering. Not while God is still on the throne. God is still in charge. Saints, lift up your hands and your heads to the hills. We can still reach out to the God of our salvation, from whence come our help. God bless you. God keep you. God God cause his light to ever shine upon you and grant you peace. God bless the technicians here today. Amen. They're doing their best. Amen. With the music. I want to say thank you to all of you for your questions and your support. Click like, subscribe, and whatever the one is there. Yes. And share. Amen. Amen. Because you know me, I just come to do a job and I'm out. But God bless you again. God keep you. And Shalom in Jesus' name.